So we know the location of the town jewels, and we've chosen these because over the last few years we've already done a couple of trials with different groups and different projects. So we've got the boys' trial, obviously, that Carrie Reichardt worked on. We've got a trial called Etched in Time, which is a series of the brass plaques. We're working on a Hansa trail, which are little artworks that are subtle that will be placed along the same route for people to discover. And we're applying for some money to do some leaflets that publicise all of these, but also to have some QR codes so people can go with their phones and get the story behind the trail. So it adds to the things that people can do in the town, and so the town jewels route goes from Scott House, which was the workhouse, to Hutton Tower, which is just along Skirkbeck Road, the play area opposite, and then around the corner goes the post office sorting station. And then if you go turn left onto John Adams Way and then right opposite the Salvation Army, there's a little car park there. And I think that is the perfect place for us to think of as a series of mosaic installations there, to give that character, because at the moment, if I'm honest, it's completely unattractive. It's got bins and GPO connection boxes and stuff, and it's just unthought of, uncared for, unloved.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think it needs a significant, you can't just put up a bird box and a bat box and make a transition to that space. Actually, we've got to think about more of an impact so that it changes from what it is now, which is an area that everybody ignores, to an area that's got a story, an area that's got some colour, an area that's got some interest. And when people are walking past, they'll go, what is that? And they'll go and walk and have a look.
It'd be a pleasure to look at.
And because it's opposite the Salvation Army, I think it would be nice to, so people do come out of that building when they're doing various workshops and sessions and sit and have a fag and chat on whatever. So in the fullness of time, to put a seat there.
Mm-hmm.
Which might be an exec fee. I don't know whether you've seen the one that's
been. Yeah, that would be great fun.
It could be that we find the money to pay for something like that. It's a substantial mosaic feature, but it's also the place where you could mount some of the others.
That'd be great. Yeah.
So there's that area opposite Salvation Army. Then the next one is the Buttons Garden.
Mm-hmm.
So they're turning the back garden of what was the vicarage into a community garden. And again, it's got a little bit of a social thing going on, in as much as people use it as a food bank and they go there with their kids, and so they want to do some activities to entertain the kids. They're going to put in, or I'm trying to persuade them to put in an attractive entrance to one side of the vicarage so that it actually makes a statement to the general public that this is a public space, rather than you have to go through the vicarage or the side door to get to it. So again, I think in the fullness of time there's opportunity to do something ambitious and significant there. It's just too soon to say exactly what it is.
Yeah.
Because there are so many people involved in the development of the Potos Community Garden, we're thinking about working with them as a town dual site a little bit later, because there's so many people that have got different ideas of what it should be. I don't want us to be competing with the community groups. We want them to get their area, the play area, the theatre area, the cafe, sorted. Get that established, and then we can talk about how art can enhance what it is that they want to do.
Yeah.
Then the last one is Centenary Methodist Church, and then the final one is Central Park. So the town jewels route goes all the way through the town from Scott House to Central Park.
Ah, brilliant. That's fabulous.